Hello dear students, I am Fatima Baby. I will be teaching you social science. It consists of three parts. They are history, civics and geography. Now let us see chapter 1 in history. Introduction to history.
What is history? When the past events are studied carefully and systematically on the basis of available material remains and records, it is called history. And the person who carries out such studies and records the findings is called a historian. History and historians. Do you know how historians arranges the events? They do it in the chronological order, that is, events first followed by events that happened later. So according to the chronological order, in history, we find dates with BC or AD. BC is the short form of before Christ, and AD means Anno Domini. It's a Latin word that is in the year of the Lord. Anno Domini means the year of the Lord. AD is usually written before the number. Example, AD 150, which means 150 years after the birth of Jesus Christ. And in the recent times, we usually do not put AD before the year. The dates for BC go backwards. Thus, 232 BC will come before 185 BC. 200 BC, 100 BC, then 50 BC. To calculate the number of years between a date in BC and one in AD, the two should be added together. Example, 250 BC and AD 150 means 400 years. We have to add both the numbers. Now, according to the chronological order, the history is divided into three parts: ancient, medieval, and modern. Ancient period we study in class 6th standard, medieval and modern in 7th and 8th standard. Let us see about the dividend of history. History is divided into prehistory and history. At the beginning, man did not lead a settled life but wandered from place to place. He did not know how to read and write. The period of man's existence for which we have no written records is called a prehistory. And that period of time for which we have written records is known as a history. Source material. According to the source material, historians find the evidence and proofs of the things. There are two types of source materials. Historians are more like a detectives. They have conclusions from clues and evidences, which are also called source materials. There are two types, archaeological and literary. Archaeological source material, artifacts. Artifacts, toys, weapons, jewelry, coins, tools, pottery, and etc. By studying the remains of artifacts, historians can tell us about the skills man had mastered and about man's lifestyle. Let us see the other things. Inscription and monuments. Three archaeological sources. Archaeological sources. Now, second, inscriptions. Inscriptions, by studying a coin, scholars find many things about the social and economical condition. And Indian coins tell us about trade between India and other countries. Third point, monuments. Writings engraved on rocks, pillars, metal plates, clay tablets, wall of temples, houses and tombs and so on are called inscriptions. Inscriptions provide a lot of information like kings and their names, dates, etc. Literary source material. All written records are known as literary source materials. Most of the available literary sources are hard written documents, manuscripts, written on bhojpatra and palm leaves. Literary source material, religious and secular literary source materials. Literature not connected with religion is called secular literature. Example, Kautilya's Arthashastra and Kalidasa's Abhinav Shakuntala. The two books are important of secular literature. History that we read is the result of lifelong research by many scholars, students. So love your history. Thank you.